Ray Brown was telling me the first day you appeared at Surf City, I believe, the band are all out there, and you ran out. Your introduction was to run, jump, and then when you hit the ground, everyone did steps and all the. You had an amazing.
And there was only 20 people
on
there. Yes.
Yeah, there weren't a lot of people.
There's more people on the stage.
Appreciate this, but were you always into dance? Because then you came up with the, what was it called? The thing.
The Mod's Nod.
Mod's Nod.
That was to counter the surf stomp, because we were playing rhythm and blues, really.
Yeah.
And there was a sort of a fusion there of rockabilly, which is where I began anyway, and rhythm and blues. I always liked all of that sort of music, and still do. And we came over playing what I suppose you could call it in those days British rhythm and blues. We'd now call it Kiwi rhythm and blues.
Right.
And, of course, we came over and we struck all of the stomp thing and all these big surfies, and they're all going and stomping around, and they wanted to wipe out all night. And we didn't mind. You know, our drummer liked playing. Jimmy didn't mind playing it once or twice a night, but it was interfering with the rest of our act and our music. So what we had to do was to come up with a different dance, because the stomp was so powerful, whereas in New Zealand, surfing's always been big, but the stomp was nothing.
No, they never heard of it.
So I created the Mod's Nod, this thing. Because if I thought if I can just nail their feet to the floor and make them move.
Your name, your surname is Forte, correct?
Yeah, right.
Is that the correct name, or is that one that you took for a stage?
Oh, no. Fabian is my real first name. It's Fabiano in Italian.
Right.
And on my birth certificate, they just dropped off the O somewhere.
Yeah. 25 years in the business.
Yeah.
15 years of age, you were earning something like $18,000 a week, correct?
Or was it a night?
It was a night? Holy mackerel. Who, number one question there, at 15, you don't often look at your books.
No.
So who actually did that little bit of research and found that out? And secondly, how in the heck did you handle it?
It's all bull anyway.
All right.
Who knows where they came up with that figure?
Yeah.
Life was very good to me,
right.
And, you know, so it was a lot of money for those times. Mm. Now, they just picked a figure out of the blue. I don't know where that came up with, but it was good money. I was very lucky.
So you're earning that sort of money at that age. Were you getting it yourself, or were they banking it for you?
Well, they put up a trust fund, and then I was awarded the court of Pennsylvania. And after all expenses, thank God I was able to take care of my family. That was the whole sole purpose of me getting into the business anyway.
I believe, you had problems.
My dad was very ill.
Uh-huh. And
so
you had to sort of look after them.
Yeah, and I had no intent in being in the business. Right. I was 14 and a half. I was looking for, my date on Saturday.